وقت مولانا والأخفن
بس الأخفن
مدد في مدد
مدد مدد مدد مدد مدد مدد مدد مدد مدد مدد مدد مدد مدد مدد يا مدد مدد يا مولانا سلطان يا جل وعلا سيدنا محمد الحقاني مدد يا رسول الله مدد موتا ومدد يا حبيبنا يا حبيب الله موتا مدد يا ربنا يا الله تعالى قلوبنا خشوعا عارفين علمنا يا الله فهمنا يا الله اللهم ارزقنا الادب يا ارحم الراحمين يا الله اللهم ارزقنا الدم لربه فاحسن تاديب يا ارحم الراحمين امدنا يا مولانا بمددك مدد شمال الحصان From which station tonight?
Up in the book. أهلا شيخ يحيى مدد يا صاحب المدد always we ask مدد without مدد we are useless without مدد from مولانا سلطان الأولياء الناظم حقاني مولانا سلطان أبي عبد الله الفاز الثاني مدد الطالب عن شيخ مدد سيدنا أبو بكر الصديق بمدد and the conversation of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the divinely madad of Allah Almighty is not coming then we are nothing we are zero zero is nothing if the zero if you put zero on the left side of the one what it will be nothing you know and also if you put zero on the right side of the one what it will be nothing all they need the one if you put one then you put zero right side and zero it will be 100 another zero it will be 1000 another zero it will be 100,000 another zero it will be 1,000,000 another zero 10,000,000 100,000,000 how much you put zero on the right side of the one it will be huge number and every number need one two to be two it need one the two to be three it need one The four to be four, it needs one. The five to be five, it needs one. Every number to appear, it needs one. And he is the one, Allah Almighty. And we are all existing by him. Without him, we are like zero, nothing. By Allah Almighty, the one, Allah Almighty, then we are existing. We are appearing. We are something. Without the one, we are nothing, zero. And from this we are shadows, no existence for us, only the existence of Allah Almighty. And for this, all of us, we must know that Allah Almighty, He created us from nothing, and He is returning us also to nothing. سُبْحَانَ مَنْ خَلَقَ الْخَلْقَ مِنَ الْعَدَمِ فَعَدَمَهُ Allah Almighty created everything from a void, nothing. And then he will return them to nothing, no existence, finish. Only he is existing by himself. He doesn't need to be existing by anyone. He is existing himself by himself. Where all creations, we are existing by him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Without Allah Almighty, no appearance for us, nothing. We will not be appealed. We will not be created. He is the creator. He created us. And we are appearing by Him. And we are existing by Him. Otherwise, we will be then completely in Adam, in nothing. And for this Allah Almighty, He was a hidden treasure. And when His will and His wish to be known, He said, I was a hidden treasure, I wish to be known. I created creation to know me by me. And for this Allah Almighty to be known, He wants to be known. So to be known, He creates, appeals from the divine, the God, the world of command of Allah Almighty. Allah Almighty ordering, His absolute identity ordering, be, as it was appearing, the reality of field of Prophet Sayyidina Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. The divine, the ocean, the divine, the God, the ocean of life were appearing and taking the shape and the figure of Muhammadun Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And Allah Almighty praising His life, saying to this divine, the God, the ocean of life, by the picture of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you are my secret, and you are my ocean of mercies, and on you I am endorsing all realities and all oceans of wisdoms and secrets and knowledge and light and love. And you will be the one representing me, and from you all creation will be appearing. And Allah Almighty blessing this reality, this God, divinely God, the ocean of life, which Allah named it by Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, He blessed him by teaching him by the Holy Quran. He teaching him, Allah Almighty, by revelation, giving to him from Allah Almighty, inspiring him. There was no language to talk between Allah Almighty and Rasulullah. Allah was giving, and Rasul, the reality of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, were taking and translating the divinely tongue of Allah Almighty to Holy Quran, to Arabic world, to give it to all prophets and all nations, all children of Adam alayhi salam. Allah Almighty giving wahi, giving revelation from Him, inspiring Rasulullah, and Rasulullah then translating to all creation. And He was the divine, the God, the tongue of Allah Almighty, whom He was translating the language of Allah Almighty, what Allah Almighty teaching him, what Allah Almighty giving him divine the knowledge to be translated according to the ability and the mind and the heart of all the creation appearing from this reality, Muhammadun Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And for this Allah Almighty telling him, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. I am sending you, you are my, I am sending you that you will be representing my divine, the ocean of the most merciful for all creation. Whatever appearing from La ilaha illallah will be covered by your mercies, which is representing my divine, the ocean of the most merciful Allah Almighty. And that is the reality of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. From one name of Allah Almighty, Allah Almighty saying, Al-Rahman, 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 from one name, Al-Rahman, Allah Almighty, dressing all these divine the ocean of knowledge, ordering, which means that He is ordering Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to give all creation and all the manifestations and all whatever appearing from La ilaha illallah should let them by the divine, the godly tongue of Allah Almighty according to the name of Rahman, according to the attribute of the merciful Ar-Rahman, to name Ar-Rahman, to the attribute of Ar-Rahman. And he was not allowing him to teach them or to give them according to the divine, the godly tongue of Allah Almighty, according to the other 99 names and the greatest name of Allah Almighty. He told them, only teach them and cover them by the mercies and give them the divine, the teaching only from one name, Ar-Rahman. This is enough for them. And Rasulullah kept for him the divine, the ocean of knowledge according to the 99 names, the other 99 names. And there is a very huge ocean of knowledge which is related directly to the greatest name of Allah Almighty, also addressed to the reality of field of prophet Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And also Allah Almighty telling him, this, keep it for you, don't give it to creation. This is the secret of field of prophecy of prophet Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is the secret of prophecy of you, my beloved Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This keep it hidden knowledge, not to be opened until Yawm al-Qiyamah, in day of judgment, when Allah Almighty wants to open this knowledge and rest all children of Adam, all creation, by the lives of the 99 names and the greatest name. Allah will open these, divine the ocean of knowledge, and you will find that for every name of Allah Almighty there is a Holy Quran.
Allah.
As the Holy Quran of from the name of Al-Rahman, Allam al-Quran, the Rahman taught the Holy Quran, you will find for every name, for the Rahim, for the As-Salam, Al-Malik, Al-Quddus, Dhul Jalali wal Ikram, for every name there is a Holy Quran, and all of them endorsed in the reality of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And all of them, they are in the heart of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And for this Allah Almighty praising Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Look, subhanallah, the difference between Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When Allah Almighty wants to descend on Sayyidina Musa, the Holy Torah, the Holy Book, the Torah, Allah Almighty, he told him, don't look, Ya Musa. He told him, no, Allah Almighty, I want to see you. I am talking with you, I want to see you and to take this Holy Torah from you. He told him, you cannot look at this mountain where you are standing. If this mountain, if I am going to reflect my light on this mountain, if this mountain will be remaining, then you can see me and take the Torah from me. And then when Allah Almighty appearing and shining over this mountain of Sinai, Allah Almighty made the mountain was totally melted. No more mountain, it was totally desert sand, and Sayyidina Musa fell down, unconscious. When he wake up, he told him, oh, forgive me, I am repenting to you, Allah Almighty, and I am the first believer. وَأَنَا أَوَّلُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. And I am the first believer and the first mu'min. And then Allah Almighty was engraving the Torah on tablets, on rocks. The Ten Commandments of the Holy Torah, it was given, Allah Almighty engraving them, writing them for Sayyidina Musa on two big rocks. And these rocks, they were like a tablet, what you call table. It's like a pamphlet, but from rocks, not paper.
Yeah.
How is this preserved tablet of Allah Almighty like this? It was engraved. And for this Allah Almighty telling Musa, you cannot carry my light. You cannot, your body, physical body, can carry the Holy Torah. I am engraving them on rocks. And then Sayyidina Musa was taking these rocks where the Holy Torah was engraved and written on them, and he came coming back to children of Israel. وإذ رسول الله سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم what Allah Almighty was saying. He was saying, my beloved Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل لرأيته خاشعا متصدعا من خشية الله. فهم؟ لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل الله. Only the heart of Rasulullah, the element of the heart of Rasulullah can carry the Holy Quran which Allah Almighty descended from one name, Ar-Rahman. How about the heart of Rasulullah who is carrying all Holy Qurans according to the 99 names and the greatest name of Allah Almighty? See how much Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and all other Prophet. How is the difference? And for this one, Sayyidina Musa was telling, oh Allah Almighty, always you are mentioning to me to believe in seals of Prophet Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and that you love Rasulullah, and I am the one whom I love you and you love me, that you are talking with me. You don't talk with anyone, oh Allah Almighty. Only you allow me to talk with you. If he is like this, why you are preferring seals of prophets on me? Then Allah Almighty getting upset from Sayyidina Musa. He was scolding him. Be careful, Musa. Behave yourself in my divinely presence. All of you, Musa, and all prophets, and all awliya, all children of Adam alayhi salam, all creation with malaika, with jinn, with mankind, all of you are making your best to please me. You are worshipping, you are doing your best by worshipping, praying, fasting, doing every good deed to please me, that I will be pleased. And I am, oh Allah Almighty, the Creator, the Lord, Allah Almighty. I am doing my best to please my beloved Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَلَسَوْفَ يُعْطِيكَ رَبُّكَ فَسَرْضَى. Allah Azza wa Jal, Allah is saying this in the Holy Quran. Allah Almighty telling him, I am going to give and my, do my best to give you to be pleased, then I will be pleased. When you, my beloved Muhammad, you will be pleased, then I am pleased. Like this, Allah Almighty addressing to seals of Prophet Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And for this, don't think that we are connected to any ordinary power. No, we are connected to the highest station, godly station of Allah Almighty. the station which all prophets they save you. Like this, we are one who connected with Muhammadun Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sending 124,000 awliya as Rasul of Rasulullah. Messenger of Rasulullah between the ummah, between the nation, there are 124,000 awliya. 124,000 awliyaullah. In every period of time, if any one of them passed away quickly before he died, will be appointed another one on his behalf to carry on the secret from Rasulullah. And all of them to serve and to connect the nation of Rasulullah with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And all of them, they are in need. All these 124,000 awliya Allah, they are in need to whom? To the one who is dressing the secret of prophecy of Rasulullah through Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. And for this, the Sultan of Awliya in every period of time will represent the reality of Muhammad Rasulullah. He will be the successor of Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. And they are only 41 from time of Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Siddiq till now a day. He is between 124,000 Awliya. In every period of time, in between the 124,000 awliyaullah, there is only one in every period of time from these whom they connect all these awliya with the reality of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And from time of Rasulullah till nowadays, they are only 41. And these 41, starting by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ending now by Sultan of Awliya Mawlana Shaykh Muhammad Nazim al-Haqqani whom all Awliya, they are in need to connect themselves with him so that he will connect them with Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to be connected with Allah Almighty. Otherwise their heart will be totally finished, melted. Cannot carry the divinely ocean of knowledge and secrets which coming from Allah Almighty to the heart of Rasulullah and from the heart of Rasulullah to this, to Sultan of Awliya, to successor of Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Siddiq in every period of time. Because only his heart can carry this divinely ocean of secrets and wisdom and knowledge. And all other hearts of the Awliya, they cannot. They can carry from him, but they cannot carry directly from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As all prophets cannot carry from Allah Almighty, they can carry from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, while only Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam can carry directly from Allah Almighty. And for this, alhamdulillah, we are well connected to the high station directly. To go from this way or that way to be connected directly, we are connected with Sultan of Awliya Mawlana Shaykh Nazim, and from him to Grand Shaykh, to Grand Shaykh, to Grand Shaykh, to Grand Shaykh, to Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, to Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. While all other Awliya, all of them, their hearts must be connected with this channel of this Grand Shaykh, whom he is in his period of time is Sultan of Awliya, who represents seed of prophets, because only his heart can carry the Holy Quran which is descending on the heart of Rasulullah. Otherwise, all what you are seeing in these universes, all creation will be totally not appearing, will be no existence for them. They will be burned totally if Allah directly descending the Holy Quran on them. And for this, Allah Almighty praising Rasulullah in the Holy Quran that the Holy Quran, if it was going to come on the sun, on all creation they will be burned and not being appearing again. But I am descending it on your heart because your heart can carry this. Otherwise nothing would be can carry the Holy Quran. لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل, this is the ayat. We read it every night. لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل لرأيته خاشعا متصدعا من خشية الله. It would be totally what you say in your language, totally.
تعلم وليابهم ورشي. بالله ما الله يبين.
What is that? You understand? It would be totally destroyed. And no more to appear again if this Holy Quran descends on them. While on your heart, my beloved Muhammad, with all its secrets is descending, and your heart is like the jewel, never cracking, always completely like a jewel, diamond jewel, which can, and nothing scratch it even. Even the Holy Quran descending. And not only from the name of Al-Rahman, but all the Holy Qur'ans and teachings from all 99 names and greatest name of Allah Almighty, all coming to the heart of Rasulullah. And so this Allah Almighty then, in concluding all of them, to all these Holy Qur'an by the name of Allah, then Allah Almighty saying, لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل لرأيت أخاشع مصدع خشية الله وتلك الأمثال نضربها للناس لعلهم يتفكرون. Allah Almighty saying these examples that how all creation will be not appearing and will be destroyed totally if the Holy Quran descends them. This example for mankind, for the creation to know whom they are from Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whom they are from Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so that they will think well, they know that no one can carry these divinely oceans except fields of Prophet Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because I created his heart to be much more powerful and much more capable than all creation and universes to carry the divinely godly tongue of Allah Almighty. Then Allah Almighty saying all these knowledge, it is in the name of Allah Almighty. Say, هُوَ اللَّهُ الَّذِي لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ عَالِمُ الْغَيْبِ وَالشَّهَادَةِ هُوَ الرَّحْمَنُ الرَّحِيمُ. We really recite it after Maghrib prayer and after Fajr prayer. And these holy ayat only to teach us how, what is the value of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to Allah Almighty. And what is inside the reality of Rasulullah, what Allah Almighty endorsing in the reality of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And what Allah Almighty then ordering Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to be the one whom he is behaving and teaching all the realities of the prophets, 124,000 prophets, they were under the teaching of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Not under the teaching of Allah Almighty. Only Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was under the teaching of Allah Almighty. And the realities of all 124,000 prophets were under the teaching of the reality of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And for this Rasulullah he say, only me, I was under the behaving and teaching of Allah Almighty. أَدَّبَنِي رَبِّي فَأَحْسَنَ تَأْدِيبِي. No prophet was saying this hadith except Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah Almighty behaved me and he well behaved me. Which means he dressed me by all means of good behavior and manner and by all good, by all God the ocean of knowledge. And he well behaved me and dressed me, Allah Almighty, that I am the Lord, not the teacher or the master. I am the Lord of children of Adam alayhi salam, and no proud. أنا سيد ابن آدم ولا فخر يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying in the hadith, I am the Lord of children of Adam and no proud. I am not proud. I am not seeing myself that this something Allah granted it to me to be the Lord of children of Adam alayhi salam. And every Sultan of Awliya in his period of time, and for every period of time there is a Sultan of Awliya. And this Sultan of Awliya, he will say, I am the Lord in this time of children of Adam alayhi salam and no proud. And this time is the time of Mawlana Shaykh Nazim ala Allah ta'ala darajati da'im wa amadda'adim. This is some smelling from the reality of Mawlana Shaykh Nazim ala Allah ta'ala darajati da'im wa amadda'adim. We didn't yet reach to taste or to feel little by little. Until I will go from here, we will finish these chapters one after one from every station. This is some smelling from the reality of the Haqqani, from the reality of Sultan of Awliya, Mawlana Shaykh Muhammad Nazim al-Haqqani, whom he is the one now will say, I am the Lord of children of Adam alayhi salam of this period of time and no proud. He is the channel to carry all the divine, the God's being, ocean of knowledge coming to Rasulullah. Then they will be addressed to his heart, and from him it will be spread to 124,000 awliya around all this globe and all these universes. And from the awliya, then they will serve the ummah, the nation of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and give them prosperous life, taking suffering from them, blessing them by prosperity, and taking all burdens and erasing their sins. And changing it to good deeds, to hasanat. Hasanat, what is hasanat in English? What is hasanat? Good tidings, yani. Good tidings. Favor. Hasanat. You know what is hasanat? Good. Yani to change from sin to good. From badness to goodness. And for this, when they are erasing, and when they are cleaning, when the mother is cleaning her baby, when he will wave in his, what you call, nappy?
Nappy.
In his nappy, when he is wasting, what she will do with him? She will wash him, will clean him, then put some powder also on him, then she will kiss him, and then she will put another new nappy on him. Sometimes, if he is making so big weight, she will get upset, she will hit him. When they hit us, then you will have sickness. They will hit us, then we will have some suffering, which means they are cleaning us. They are erasing our sins and changing them from badness to goodness. For this, we will find that we have some suffering or sickness or bad burdens coming on us. Really it is not. Really it is all kind of forgiveness and the cleaning from Allah Almighty through these awliya and then through Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. While they are so mercy that when they clean us totally, then they will wash us, put powder, and they will kiss us and they will hug us. Sometimes when they hurt us too much, we will feel also from their so much hugging that we will feel a burden on us. This means they love us too much. And for this Allah Almighty saying, whenever I am sending sickness or burden, I send before it Sayyidina Jibreel alayhi salam with Malaika, with angel of salam. With Malaika whom they are carrying all these high maqams, all forgiveness, all mercies, to come on this, on my servant, and to dress him by all these forgiveness and mercies and high maqams, and erasing his sins, then I will send the sickness over him after this. I will send the sickness so that he will be clean. And anyone who died by any sickness, no grace, no questioning for him. Directly he will go to be in the divine presence of Allah Almighty. Even Allah Almighty by this sickness which he is getting and he is dying, Allah will make all his grandfather and mother to be clean. He will be a one whom Allah sacrificing him on behalf of all his ancestors. And for this, Allah Almighty saying always, be careful, don't complain. I don't like the one who complains. Always say, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Always thank me. And I am Allah Almighty, the most merciful, that I am not wishing or willing to any one of you to be in burden or suffering. I don't like anyone to suffer. Allah Almighty, He is saying, لا تظالموا إني حرمت الظلم على نفسي. Allah Almighty saying, don't be zalim to each other, don't be oppressor to each other, because I forbidden zulm, oppressing on myself. I am not a zalim, I am not an oppressor. I am the most merciful, I am the Rahman al-Rahim, the most merciful, whom I am forbidding on myself oppressing, to be oppressor. I am not an oppressor. And for this Allah Almighty saying, don't make zulm between each other. Don't be zalim. Don't be tyrant. Don't be dictator. Don't be one to do bad to another. But be humble to each other. Because I address all humbleness to the Lord of children of Adam alayhi salam, seed of Prophet Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He is the most humble, even he is the Lord of children of Adam. Rasulullah saying, I am the Lord of children of Adam and no proud. And even though Rasulullah, he was dressed by all divine, the ocean of humbleness from Allah Almighty, the most humble one. Why Shaitan, Allah dressed him by all oceans of proudness, all ocean of badness, all kinds of whatever you can imagine from bad manners is what dressed to Shaitan. So be careful not to imitate Shaitan, but imitate Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Do your best to imitate Rasulullah, to be humble, always to be imitating the one whom you like to be with him yawm al-qiyamah, whom you like to be him with him in dunya, in this life. You like your spirituality, your soul, and yourself, your ego, yourself, to be with Rasulullah or Shaitan. With Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with awliya or with follower of Shaitan. With awliya, so imitate them. Do like them, be in their line, obey them. Don't imitate Shaitan. Because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, يُحْشَرُ مَنْ تَشَبَّهَ بِقَوْمٍ فَهُوَ مِنْهُمْ. The one who imitates anyone, he will be from them. So if you imitate awliya, you will be with awliya. You imitate followers of Shaitan, you will be with the Shaitan and his followers. If you imitate Rasulullah, you will be with Rasulullah. Rasulullah saying so, Allah Almighty saying so. مَنْ تَشَبَّهَ بِقَوْمٍ, the one who make himself to imitate or looks like anyone whom he loves, Allah will make him with him. And for this, always keep yourself to be good example, to be in the station of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, station of Grand Shaykh, station of Sultan of Awliya Mawlana Shaykh Nazim, and with Awliya Allah Azza wa Jal. Allah, Allah,
Allah, Allah, Allah, Allah, Aziz Allah.
Forgive us, O Allah Almighty. We are repenting to you. We say, Astaghfirullah, Tawbah, Astaghfirullah, Rabbi, wa Atubu Ilayk. Forgive us, mercy us, make us sincere servants to you, O Allah Almighty. Bless us by blessing and good tidings for the sake of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. make us sincere ummat rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam make us sincere murid wala sheikh nazir ibn sheikh wala abdullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam sayyidina abubakr siddiq umar usman wa ali and make us kulish time of sahib al zaman sayyidina muhammad al mahdi alaihi salam and make us sincere murid and follower to imam sahib al zaman sayyidina muhammad al mahdi alaihi salam bless us by sincerity o allah almighty Bless us by love to you, love to Rasulullah, love to Mawlana and Ghanshiyah and Ghar Ghanshiyah and Ahli Bayt al-Nabi and Sahabati Rasulullah. Bless us by love to Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Bless us by love to Sahib al-Zaman Sayyidina Muhammad al-Mahdi and Ghar Awdiyah al-Allah. Ila sharaf al-Nabi Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam alayhi wa sallam. Azad al-Sahidina al-Sahid al-Sahid al-Siddiqiyun al-Fatih. Shaykh Osman waliyullah al-Fatih.
அவர்களுடைய நோக்கமாக இருக்கிறார்